What's happening, pimps and kinfolk? This your main man, Slink Johnson, a.k.a. Black Jesus, or better known as Lamar Davis, from Los Santos' own GTA 5. Sending a big shout out to my man, the real P1. Check him out and smoke yours.
What's up, y'all? It's your boy P1 back in here again. Welcome to another GTA 6 for you guys. Today we have a few things that we will be discussing, and this has to do with a lot more information that's been coming out to light. You know, it's just a lot of things that have been happening lately, and we're going to go through the videos I've been through before and then leading up to today's, you know, most recent. But the reason why I do post a lot of these things, because, you know, I like to share my community, man, especially my people. My people love me making these videos, man. For some of y'all that are just brand new to the channel, you know, bear with me. Get to know the channel first, so before you judge, you know, and just we'll go through there. But make sure you guys do subscribe to the channel. Drop a like. Turn the bells on. You know how notification systems are so whack these days. Hopefully, you'll be able to build and go from there. But now, we have some information regarding GTA 6. Now, this is the next installment that we all been waiting for, okay? The next gen GTA Online details with stuff that we had before. So I went through this before with new guns, stuff that you found on Red Dead Files. Now you're probably saying like, wait, why Red Dead Files? Because that's the most recent game that's been out. Now if you guys see all the pistols, the AKs, and everything else, even the rifles and everything else has been popping out, okay? If, even from having the Rage engine coming into place, that could be coming for the next installment. We don't know yet, but that's just something that everyone's been discussing. Now we're gonna go through here, a huge list here, a new patent, or patent, whatever you call that. All right, so a computer-based system for virtual navigation of one or more non-players characters in the game environment. The gaming environment being represented by one or more low-level nodes, joined by links in the system comprising a server for managing the virtual navigation of one or more non-player characters. One or more players, consoles, and operable communications with the server over a network. Each player console comprising a gaming platform for executing the game environment, where it said server generates a coarse graph of the low-level nodes, whatever you call that, and associate links and pathfinds on at least one of the low-level nodes, nodes, whatever. Coarse graph from a start node to a target node, wherein pathfinding of the coarse graph reduces the number of loads of low-level nodes needed by one or more players' consoles to generate a path from the start to the target mode. Now, excuse the way I'm saying things, okay, but this is some really crazy information they're giving us, man. Now, from that being talked about for the management of the next consoles, this is something, another image that, you know, it's giving us a session management control. And this right here, guys, obviously it's a monitor trigger event, determine merge split and merge session and split session. So it's like they're really doing this a different way for the next game that's gonna be coming. And, you know, you playing the game is going to show you a different way of, let's say you're switching a session. You won't notice the next change, which you already had switched, and you won't even know, like, it won't even tell you. But here's the image here, guys, of video tech showing us of what's going on here. There's texture selections of what's been going on. You know, this is all the stuff on the patent that, you know, we've seen. And, you know, we're going to give a big shout out to Big Jim Colosimo, because he found these new virtual environments, and this is what obviously they're doing with their games. And this is a whole lot of information to read. I mean, for myself, guys, I've been confused a couple times reading this, but then as more of a read down, I start seeing a lot more difference in it. But meanwhile, all these other session mergings, the possible reveals to Rockstar Games intention, like, to create a lot more populated lobbies. The patching mentions a variety of systems under the hood that could help lobbies compromise players' pools, including like avoiding card duplications. More importantly, like, you know, trying other patents, and it looks like Rockstar Games may be cooking a lot of sessions that change on the go, and to allow other players to, like, in lobbies to less disconnect disruptions. So it doesn't reveal that much of what was going on, but obviously, thanks to Jergon for putting this out, you know. And big shouts to J-Man for, you know, giving this, because we had to see something coming. But I hope you guys don't understand. Excuse my bad, you know, wording and stuff like that. But, you know, it's just something we got to get, man. But big shouts to everybody else for watching. I hope you guys understand. Y'all take it easy, guys, and enjoy the video. And think about this. What do you guys think in the comment section about all this confusion going on? Anyways, guys, hope you guys enjoy it. Today, it's Sport P1 signing out.